Come very clear, right? Even in every home today, there's so much political polarization. It's almost hard to have conversations in the family, and certainly it happens with us also in the extended family, that we've forgotten how to talk to each other without taking a stake, like a staked position, and saying, I think like this, therefore I must be right and you must be wrong, right? And similar. And if that culture spreads through society, I don't think it's good for any society. So how do we, and that's some of the work, Krishna, we are all trying to do together, is how do we almost build a curriculum for this century, right? Because we all know very clearly, we don't know how to get there, but we all know clearly that we have to reduce the friction to collaborate. We have to reduce the divides between us, because the kind of problems that we're facing, as we are facing right now with the pandemic, is that they are very global problems and they affect us all intensely personally. And the way out seems to be cooperation, and we are losing the art of doing cooperation, right? So building a societal muscle to sort of, as I said earlier, talk across divides, understand the source of the conflict, right? Understand, be able to put yourself in the other side's shoes. If that could become a new public culture, for which almost a curriculum has to be designed, which young people have to be exposed to, with projects on hand to practice that muscle with, right? That's the kind of work that we are hoping to unleash in the next few months and years. So that's what we mean by societal muscle. But I did want to bring in a slightly cautionary note in that. See, when we talk of panchayats, I mean, I don't want to fall into the trap of thinking that the earlier times were idealistic, because there are many power imbalances in society. And whether it's panchayats or kha-panchayats, sometimes in a patriarchal setup, mediation or coming to a decision can be at the cost of one section of society, right? That's why the laws, the constitutional framework, where everybody has equal rights. We have to bring that perspective also if we are going to do conflict resolution before it reaches the courts. At the end of it, we want a society which is less litigious, and yet at the table at which the dialogue happens must be a somewhat round table and not a square one with sharp edges, and a table where some people get really left out. So while we are talking about this, I do want to say that when we do the curriculum design, when we're talking about building a societal muscle, it also, as a first step, requires us to accept that we are all equal, and that this whole goal is not that one side wins, right? But something happens where, as Sri Ram was saying, the passion for everybody to reduce conflict gets reflected by nobody losing really badly, right? And that's the delicate art of it, which I'm sure Sri Ram and Justice Joseph are very much used to. So I did want to bring that in a bit before we moved on. But yes, the goal is to reduce conflict, prevent conflict. One of the successful, last point, successful ways we saw was when we supported the Water Conflicts Resolution Forum. They did a lot of work in the Cauvery Basin with the farmers between Tamil Nadu and Karnataka. They worked in the Kerala water basins, Orissa, and they made several strides where the kind of vicious politics that came in was set aside for a moment. And people were able to talk to each other and say, oh, yes, of course we can share water. At least for some time that was possible. And we have to just broaden those opportunities across society in a very structured manner. Thank you.